Hello everyone. Today I will show you how I made this cool clip for a barefoot shoe brand. It was just a short video for social media that mixed 3D work, AI and a bit of video editing. So first I needed a shoe and I got one, but I needed it in 3D. So I made a bunch of photos, like a couple hundred from all the angles, and uploaded it into a Polycam app. It made me a 3D model, which was quite good. Not perfect, but good enough. Next, I planned the scene. I wanted the shoe to fly into a view, spin a bit, and then drop on a snowy surface. When it hit the ground, snow burst out around it. I knew I could not create this effect with a single AI video generation, so I had to break it into parts. I started in Blender. I made a simple plane to act as a ground and added a little displacement to it so it wasn't totally flat. I set up the HDRI lighting to feel like a bright snowy day, and then I positioned the shoe at the right angle for the animation and did a basic render. No fancy tweaks in Blender, just the garbage like this one. Then I took the render into Midjourney and retextured it. I used quite simple prompt and added an image reference to guide the look, and Midjourney did a great job, but it often comes with the cost. What I mean by this is that it changed also the shoe, but I needed it to look as in reality. So I fixed it in Photoshop. I replaced the shoe on a retextured image with the one I already rendered. Nothing difficult because the edges were same. A bit of color correction and retouching the shoe's sole touching the ground. I used a combination of generative fill in Photoshop and stock images to create a sense of snow burst. I did that because I wanted to help Runway with narrating my vision later. I also made a clean plate. A clean plate is a picture of the background without the shoe. It is often used in filmmaking. I put that into Runway and added a small camera move. This made a parallax effect and even added falling snow. Sound generations turned out weird, but I used this one. Back in Blender, I set up the animation for the shoe. I added rotation and camera movement. I rendered the animation as a PNG sequence with a transparent background, and then I took that sequence and the clean plate into After Effects. I put them together so the shoe comes in, spins and stops. To make it even more real, I made animation from a bit lower angle. This helped show the sole of the shoe. I didn't want to animate same angle of the shoe because no matter how small the difference is, your eyes would spot that for sure. I went back to Runway to create a clip of the shoe falling and the snow bursting on impact. I played with the settings and prompts until I got a good result. I was trying the first and the last frame generations, then I tried the first and the middle frame. I was simply searching for the right setup. This one wasn't that easy to get right, but I was patient and I managed. Finally, I could put all pieces together in After Effects. However, there was still one thing missing. The fall is linear, and such thing would not happen in real life, nor does it look good at all. So I needed to add a speed ramp to the clip, but it doesn't have enough frames for that. But no worries, we got Topaz video for that. I let it turn into slow motion and I time remapped this version. Now the shoe speeds up slowly, drops fast on impact, and then slows down again. This made the motion feel a bit more natural, dynamic, and way nicer. I still feel most comfortable in the intersection of AI and standard 3D tools, because it is giving me way more control that only AI could offer me, but it will probably change in the near future. Who knows? But what we can do now with AI is unbelievable, so I am optimist. And that's it. Hopefully it helped you, maybe inspired you, or you at least like it. So thanks for watching this quick tutorial and stay tuned for next video.